Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's session of Ask Zak. And keeping with our subject of this last week, we're still focusing on broilers. And this week we're going to look at common mistakes people make in broiler farming that can cost them a lot of money and at the end of the day make or break your broiler business. So first of all, very important is people don't always secure their market before they even start farming. Remember, it doesn't help you go through all the work, grow all your broilers properly, get them at the right size, and you have nowhere to sell them. So go identify the markets in your area, see where you can get a place to deliver them to, where you can get your money so that you can go on with the next cycle. So that is one of the big ones that we usually encounter. Another one that we get is people try to start too big, too fast. Remember, if you're new in the business, start small. Remember, when you've got a small setup, it's small mistakes you make, smaller amounts of money instead of big mistakes and losing most of your capital. So always start small, learn with that small process, and grow steadily into your business. As you pick up experience, pick up knowledge, and of course, increasing your customer base. Another thing that we see is, of course, the chicken pens that's not built correctly. Remember, your housing can make or break you. Ventilation, how you put up your sails, your orientation of your chicken house looking from east to west. Those things are factors that influence your production and can decrease your production very badly if you do not do it correctly. So be very aware of it. Another thing that we always see a lot is when it comes down to your equipment. We talk about your feeders and your drinkers. A lot of people go, they want to start their poultry business, and then what happens is they start buying the equipment, but they run out of a bit of a cash flow, they run into a bit of a cash flow problem. And what happens is they say, okay, I'm not going to put in as much feeders as needed, I'm going to put in less. Now, usually what happens is you get uneven growth, cannibalism, and big problems amongst your chickens because that causes competition amongst your birds, and that can be very detrimental to your poultry farming. And last but not least, in the time that we're in the time with avian influenza that's all over the country, that's hitting the poultry industry very hard. And we come to a lot of farms and we see biosecurity measures that's not in place. When I talk about biosecurity, I'm talking about your foot bath that you have in front of your chicken house to disinfect your shoes. I'm talking about the people you allow into your poultry house. Usually it's only the people that's supposed to work there. And they are supposed to have the correct PPE. That means they have to have gumboots that they leave there and not use all over the farm, where they can trudge through diseases and bring it into your poultry house. So these few things that I mentioned is basic mistakes that we see commonly on a poultry farm. So be aware of it. And if you want to learn more, get in contact with your nearest Alzu one-stop shop or get in contact with your nearest technical advisor. We're here to help you build your business and grow as a farmer. There's lots of challenges out there and there's mistakes that you can avoid, and you can avoid them by just asking the right questions. So feel free to contact us either by the branch or by your technical advisor. So from my side, have a good evening. See you next week, same time, same place.